Oh, Eli's the shit, man. Yeah, Eli Quinters. Yeah, he's just up the street, I think.
Yeah,
he did this tattoo on me in, I don't know. It was a long time ago. Me and Scott Campbell has this too, and this other dude we used to be friends with. All three of us got that on a Super Bowl Sunday. When Eli first started tattooing down in on Canal Street at the Unimax shop. Yeah, he's a good dude, man.
Yeah.
Real funny and positive guy.
I had this impression too.
Yeah. He's fucking funny. He's always smiling, that dude.
Young girls are coming to the canyon, and in the mornings I can see them walking. I can no
Questa è la terza puntata di True Love. True Love racconta il mio viaggio negli Stati Uniti per incontrare 10 dei migliori tatuatori americani e ad ognuno di loro chiederò di farmi un tatuaggio. Dopo essere stato da Billy Hunter Robinson, oggi andrò allo Smith Street Tattoo Parlour, sempre qui a Brooklyn. E, lo studio è stato appena aperto da 3 dei tatuatori più noti qui a New York: Steve Boltz, Bert Krak e Eli Quinters. E oggi sarà proprio Eli a tatuarmi.
What were the hands that you liked?
I was looking at these hands, but...
What did you like about them? Just sort of like... Because I could do like more of my style of that, like a little bit more realistic,
sure,
maybe
absolutely.
With the eye in the center like that. That could be cool.
See you then, yeah.
So we got a couple options we can do.
Maybe down here. That way,
that size, is that same
one? That's it. Okay. Cool. It's good.
I'm going to eat real quick and then I'll finish up this drawing.
Okay. All right, go check that out. All right, you ready?
Yeah. Are you ready?
Oh, yeah. Always ready.
I met a couple of days ago Wesley Lang.
Yeah.
Westland.
Yeah.
I was looking at his tattoo.
He's got crazy tattoos, right? Yeah, he's awesome. I did a tattoo on him pretty early on. Did like a man's ruin type thing, just a little guy. He's really awesome. I went to art school. Unfortunately, I went to art school.
Unfortunately,
yeah. Well, it was good that I went because the kid that taught me to tattoo, I met him at art school.
Yeah.
And we're still real good friends. And I definitely learned some things about drawing at art school, but I'd say overall I learned a lot more just by wanting to learn how to tattoo and wanting to learn how to draw tattoo imagery.
Yeah, always
like this. I grew up in a real small little redneck town in Utah called Heber City.
Never heard, but...
Exactly, nobody ever has. I moved to New York on my 19th birthday.
What's it called, Beaver City?
Heber City, but there is a Beaver City, Utah.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Remember that movie Footloose? You ever see that movie Footloose?
Yeah.
It's just like that, yeah. Yeah, that's where they filmed that in my hometown.
Okay.
Right? It was pretty cool. I don't know, my dad's a horse trainer, so that's why we live there.
Really?
Yeah, he's a cowboy. I like a lot of like sort of just Western themed things in general, whether it's like kind of the Chicano style or like a old Western. I like the old Italian spaghetti Westerns a lot, you know, it's the good, the bad, the ugly, all that stuff. I watch that shit a lot at home. That stuff gets me pumped up. But yeah, my dad is a horse trainer, my mom helped raise horses, so I do a lot of stuff with horses in my stuff. I really like horses and just the cowboy imagery.
Wish?
Shit. My dad, it's a saying my dad had when I was a kid. I'd ask him for anything. He'd say, well, wish in one hand, shit in the other. See which one fills up first. So I had to get that for him. Yeah. My dad's half Mexican.
Yeah.
So when I was a kid, I always thought that was really cool that I was part Mexican. So I just sort of attracted it to me. And then also, just being a skater when I was a kid, seeing all like the suicidal tendencies and the Dogtown lettering and all that stuff, you know, you can't help it. But love that stuff. And do like a really light blue moon, yellow stars, and then brown in the hand.
Yeah.
And a blue eye. Do you have any opposition to that? New York. New York was sort of weird for a long time. It was illegal here until 1996. So I think that tattooing was kind of weird here because it was just people were doing it so much out of their kitchens and stuff like that. There wasn't like a tattoo culture like there is out in California, you know what I mean? Okay. Like San Francisco's got a great tattoo culture where there's a lot of good tattooers. And I think New York's starting to develop that now. And I think it's starting to develop a style, like a New York style. And I think Bert and Steve are very much a part of that, you know, like using that like ton of black shading and just mean, simple designs. I love being able to say that I tattoo in Brooklyn and I live in Brooklyn, you know. Yeah. Sounds tough. There's a tattoo artist who actually recently quit named Chris Kahn. He was one of my favorite tattooers and I've just sort of tried to emulate his style a lot, but have sort of tried to make it a little bit more my own. But he's got a very delicate...
Huh? Is this an original piece?
Yep. Oh, really? Man, if you wouldn't mind coming back, I'd love to check out all your tattoos.
Oh, man.
He did all this, and then Adoy did this.
Oh, man. Dude, is there any way I could get some photos of this? If I don't get some photos of this, I'll be in trouble with all the guys I work with. So do you mind giving me like... No, let me get it now. If I don't get it now, I promise I'll get yelled at. Yeah, I don't personally understand why you'd want to quit. Like, to me, this is just the best job ever. Like, even if you're doing tribal armbands all day long, it's still better than... you know, washing dishes or anything like that. But at the same time, he tattooed a lot longer than I have, you know? So we'll see how I feel when I've been in it, you know? It'll be 9 years in February I've been tattooing. I think when he quit, he'd been in it like around 20 years. So we'll see how I feel after I've been doing this for 20 years. I'll probably hate it to death, you know? I hope not, but.
Who knows?
Yeah. I'm not good at anything else, so I better not hate it. I wasn't even expecting it to look like that.
What's that?
Like this.
Yeah, it looks good.
I like it.
Yeah, I like it.
Altri tatuatori mi avevano detto dello stile malinconico di Eli. Infatti i simboli che usa richiamano l'immaginario dark e rendono i suoi tatuaggi inconfondibili.
We got it all here. Smith Street Tattoo Parlour, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Yeah,
man.
My pleasure.